if you want to learn about programs and guidelines and all that good stuff, that's not what I do. What I do is I help you understand how to create a process. I help you understand how to influence and persuade a sale. I help you in identifying how to be very efficient in your sales process so that you can generate a system that continuously feeds you the revenue that you need to feel comfortable, to feel that sense of freedom, to build equity to where you're irreplaceable to your company. Make sense? What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Sales Remastered. My name is Daniel. I'm your host, and I just completed my morning ritual of going to the gym. And I'm moving, my blood's flowing, and I'm getting ready. I'm getting ready to get into my optimal level, and I hope you are too. If you haven't joined me before in one of these vlogs or one of these video shares, one of the daily habits that I do or that I have been doing, and you'll get a chance as you gander at the profile. So if you're first time actually discovering Sales Remastered, hit the subscription button below. And then if you hit that bell, you're going to be notified of any of the interesting topics that I come up with and I upload, and you'll be one of the first to watch it. And you're just one video away of finding that one hack, that one adjustment, that one minute little detail that we sometimes often overlook. And just with that one video, that could ultimately unlock the gate to actually help you get what it is you're trying to get. And so anyway, in this video, in this share, what I plan to do is share with you some real helpful information that's going to boost not only your mindset, but it's also going to help you make a couple extra bucks. So if you like making money, you're going to want to stick around. Now, before I begin the video, I want to give you guys an update. For those of you who've been following me, you may have already downloaded my free sales script. You're going to want to go ahead and go to salesremastered.com and request an updated copy. Just do it, because it's been updated, it's been revamped, and now there's this, what I like to call, conversion checklist. It's an actual checklist that's now attached to the script that goes over key points that you need to have within your sales conversation to better prepare yourself to convert that conversation into a closed sale. Now, what I'm talking about by a closed sale, like, they're closed, bro. Like, they're fully vested with you. You can literally hand the baton off to operations or processing and have complete confidence that they're not going to, you know, leave you. Their loyalty is with you. And if you follow that checklist, you're going to increase your chances of creating a more systematic process. And that's actually the topic of the video, that will continue feeding your pipeline so that it's an automated machine. It's more of a conveyor belt rather than, you know, recruiting. Right? And why I say that the theme of this video is going to be about systematic processes is because one thing that I've noticed is, you know, working in the sales floor, working in a sales environment, I think that we as salesmen have different views on things and different mindsets. And if you didn't catch yesterday's video, it had to do with our perspective, right? Like the views and the three habits of most successful people in 2019. And I guess in this video, this is going to be definitely the opposite of that. It's going to be the views and the perspective of those who are mediocre and average. And if any of these characteristics sound familiar to you, don't worry. A lot of the times it's not your fault. So you still got time to change it. And I hope that this video helps you discover why you should change it. But anyhow, with the perspective of the average and the mediocre, when they come into an environment, they're more or less, their energy is determined by that environment. So their outcome and their results are determined by that source, meaning they're relying on external sources to generate their desired result. So for example, in leads, right? Like if you're currently taking in leads right now and you're going through the process because your manager or your sales trainer or your company policy is to do the full application, regardless if there's a deal there or not. Like, you know instinctively there's no deal, but you're told to do the 5-minute tap dance. Well, here's why you should choose my company, and tell me about yourself. And you know, you already know damn near 5 minutes into the conversation that you don't have a deal, but because your company policy is to complete that application, go through that 45-minute phone call, and you're going to be monitored or you know, ridiculed if you're not on the phone for 9 hours out of the 10 hours that you're there, your influence to spend your time spinning your wheels. Make sense? And so some people who are coming into sales every day are wired and trained to spend time for the company's best interest, right? Now, I'm not saying don't work against your company's best interest. What I'm saying is that when you work for a company as a salesman, it is a partnership. It's not just, you're not a servant. You both of you profit. The company stays alive because of your efficiency, and you stay alive because of their comp. Make sense? So you're not like the receptionist of the company where you could be easily replaced. Like if you become strong and an efficient salesman, you grow this equity where companies want you, right? Because sales is one of the only departments, it's actually the only department that's not a cost center, meaning that sales is the only department that actually covers its own cost. It covers its base. Because if it doesn't, then your company does not have any chance of scale, right? Your company has no heartbeat. It has no life without sales. A company is a company because its ability to sell. And so understand your purpose and understand your equity and your value. But going back to the perspective of where most go in and they're wired, they're not necessarily thinking for themselves. And so this creates resistance, and it creates animosity. It creates kind of this grudge. Because you get upset at the process rather than looking at the process and hacking it to make it your own. So for example, if you are being hounded because you need enough talk time, fine, put in the talk time, but make sure that the talk time is being put towards people who deserve your talk time. I think that we kind of go along the process and we expect things to happen in return. So in other words, if my employer told me I gotta be on the phone for 6 hours a day, I'm going to expect them to deliver me nothing but good data to speak to 7 times, you know, for 6 hours of the day. If they delivered me bad data and horrible leads in my perspective, then I'm going to say, oh, well, they want me on the phone for 6 hours. You know, there's that animosity, right? There's that resilience. There's that kind of that fight, that pushback. And that's the last place where you want to go, because when you start going down that rabbit hole, you start thinking that it's greener on the other side, and you start blaming external things. And again, it's not your fault. It's just because the way we're wired, it's the way we grew up, it's the way that we saw our elders, and it's a much, much deeper level. But that's one of the things, or one of the reasons why people remain mediocre, remain average, is because they're simply following a systematic process that they didn't design. And so if you want to learn how to design a systematic process that is profitable and allows you to reap the fruits of being in sales, then you have to find a coach and a mentor, or you have to find a channel like At Sales Remastered that continuously feeds your brain and lets you know that you have more freedom than you think. You have more freedom than you believe. You see, there's a saying that goes, you know, nod your head and keep it moving, right? Like, in other words, like you stay in your lane. So you don't push back, or you don't fight back upper management, because then you're just putting yourself in a different lane. Make sense? So then don't. But at the same time, you got to walk to your own drum roll. You got to march to your own drum. I hope that's the way you say it. But you got to create your own rhythm. And the only way you're able to do that is just understand the system in place and understand how to rehack the system. Make it work for you. So if I was advised to spend time on doing a full application, right? Like that was my whole motive. That was my whole goal, is because I have to get as much social security numbers as possible. I have to pull credit no matter what, because my company is just farming data, and that's their primary motive. Well, then what I'm going to do is hack the conversation to the point where I'm going to identify within the first 5-10 minutes if I can even make a deal. And if I can't make a deal, then what I'm going to do is start saying things that's going to push them away to where I can't get the social security number. Make sense? We already know what those things are. But you know, you start talking about cost, you start talking about rate, you start talking, right? That actually pushes people away. So maybe you bring that up and you force the issue of ending the phone conversation. So that way you're not stuck on the phone. Now you might be like, but dude, I'm gonna get in trouble. Man, you're gonna get in trouble if you don't make any sales. You're not going to get in trouble if you get results. You're not going to get in trouble if you're one of the highest top earners. You have to open your mind. You have to understand that you are not there for the base pay. Got it? You are not there to do admin work. You're there to originate business. The only way that you're going to keep your seat is if you continuously originate business. And you can't originate business if you spend all your time with Jim, who just got out of the bankruptcy court yesterday with a 330 FICO and hasn't worked in like 3 years, but he got this side business where he doesn't claim any of the income. And he rents three of the bedrooms inside of his house, but he doesn't claim any of that rental income. Got it? Oh, and by the way, he's in the middle of a divorce that isn't finalized yet. There's no point in spending 45 minutes with that dude when you already know that you can go out and connect with someone else who needs your service, who needs your help. And if there's any fight back, then you got to fight for yourself. You got to stick up for yourself. You have to remind them that my job, the reason why you hired me, was to generate business. And that's what I'm going to do. Right? You just have to be confident in that. Because I see it too many times from mediocre agents or people who are below par who's just kind of going with the flow. They don't understand that being a salesman is very much like being an entrepreneur, where if you don't make the transaction, if you don't put yourself in position to earn and win the sale, you're not going to get paid. You're not going to have the job security anyway. So what's the point in having to follow the policy code, right? If the policy code doesn't put you in a better position to reap the benefit of actually having the job anyway, then why do you have the job, right? There's a lot of companies that allow you to work with ultimate freedom, and then there's a lot of companies that very strict, and some of us need that, and I get it. It's okay, but you can't get mad of not making the money that you see with people who understand the freedom that they have to create their own business, to create their own engine. So whether you work in a kiosk or whether you work in this small cubicle or whether you work in, you know, like your home office, the bottom line is that's your business. If you don't have the creativity to generate the traffic and create a process that delivers the revenue and the sales, you're not going to... You need to get out of sales, boo-boo. You need to go into operations. You need to go, you know, into HR. You need to go into payroll or something like that. Maybe you like numbers, fine. Go do something in accounting. But don't go into sales if you're not going to be creative enough to create the climate that you need to change the surroundings, to actually be creative enough to establish a process that works for you. It can't just work for your company. Because if you're just working for your company, then you're really just there for the base pay. You're really just there for the light, you know, the insurance, right? But please understand that I had one question where a loan officer hit me up on a direct message and like, hey D, I just got started. My employer told me that they're gonna give me a certain amount of base pay and that change. What would you recommend? The only thing that I could reply back was like, I was like, we in this line of work, we don't work for the base pay, right? That the bottom line. You don't, like, you want to know what my base pay? My base pay is minimum wage. Now what? Like, I have no attention put towards the base pay because that's not what I'm there for, and that's not what you should be there for too. You know, if you're more about base pay and benefits and life insurance, you can get that same incentive by working in operations. You know, maybe that's more in your level, and you still get a chance to work with a company if that's your primary motive. But when you get into sales, you need to understand that there are just certain ways to look at things. And if you stick around here at Sales Remastered, I'm gonna share with you a few different ways to improve the way you look at these things so that you can improve the results that you get by doing what you do every day anyway. So if you have any questions below, definitely leave the comments below, and you're always more than welcome to learn a little bit more about me. Check me out at Sales Remastered on Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, Twitter. I'm even on Snapchat. You can go to salesremastered.com for the free script. You could check out the courses that I have available online. If it seems right for you, hit me up directly. If you want to learn more about it, you can email me at help@salesremastered.com. You're more than welcome to email me any questions to figure out the program's right for you. And if it's not right for you, I'll tell you. I'll say that's not right for you. This one is, or maybe another you know, training course might be better for you. If you want to learn about programs and guidelines and all that good stuff, that's not what I do. What I do is I help you understand how to create a process. I help you understand how to influence and persuade a sale. I help you in identifying how to be very efficient in your sales process so that you can generate a system that continuously feeds you the revenue that you need to feel comfortable, to feel that sense of freedom, to build equity to where you're irreplaceable to your company. Make sense? So I hope that this video helps. Please like, comment, and share. And if you haven't by now, check out the links in the notes of this video and add me to your stream. If you are on Facebook, if you are on YouTube, if you are on Twitter, or you're on Instagram, or you're on Snapchat, if you're on any of those platforms, add me to your feed because I have different content spread throughout all different media channels, and you're definitely going to want to add me to your LinkedIn. Check out my pedigree, look at my background, so you understand that the information you're learning today is coming from someone in it today. I'll see you on the next episode. Bye.